Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website, that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for October the 17th of 2019, well, it is titled Moons of Saturn. So what do we see here? Well, not all of the moons of Saturn, which now number over 80 with recent discoveries, 82 known moons of the planet Saturn. But we do see five of them here in this image. And starting on the left, we see one of the smaller moons, and that is the moon known as Janus. And the second one in is known as Pandora, seen there very close to the ring system itself. These are two relatively small moons by comparison, on the order of 100 or so kilometers in size, one a little more than that, one a little bit less, but very small. So we're talking about things that are only a few dozens of miles across. And they are therefore generally inactive little cratered objects, and they are primarily composed of ice. And we'll actually see that when we get to the outer solar system, even as you look at objects out here, what we see, while it may resemble rock to us from a distance, it is really everything is made up of icy material. And if there is rocky material, it is deeper down in the core. So these are two of Saturn's small moons, which are similar to the 20 or so that were recently announced that are even smaller than these. But they're really relatively small moons by comparison to several of the others that we will look at. Now, the next one that we look at towards the middle of this frame is Enceladus. And that is about a middle sized moon of Saturn. Saturn has only one large moon that did not make it into this image, and that is the great moon Titan with an atmosphere. Enceladus is interesting because it has a very fresh surface. It has some cratered areas on part of its surface, but it also has some very smooth areas lacking craters, telling us that it has been resurfaced relatively recently. And it is a larger moon by comparison to the other two. This is about 500 kilometers across, so a couple of times larger than either of the two other moons that we've looked at previously. So it does have some activity, which is still unusual for a moon that small. However, with the larger planet, we can get some tidal forces that can, at times, depending on the conditions and the interactions between this moon and the planet and the other moons, cause some internal heating, which may be something about what has gone on here. Now, the other two moons that we want to look at, off towards the right side of the image, we can see Mimas, which is the littler one in appearance here. And that is about 400 kilometers across. So very similar in size to Enceladus that we just looked at. It is actually, you can't tell from this image, but this is the one that is sometimes known as the Death Star moon because of a very large impact that can give it the appearance of the Death Star from certain angles when it's viewed. Now, the final moon that we're looking at over on the far right hand side, cut off in this image, is the moon Rhea. Now, this is the second largest moon of Saturn after Titan, and it is 1500 kilometers across, so it is about three times larger than the last two moons that we looked at here. It is a very heavily cratered moon, so this one does not show signs of activity as Enceladus did previously. It is very heavily cratered, looks in many ways like our own moon, although understanding that when we look at it, all those craters that we see are actually craters in ice, not craters in rock as we are used to seeing. So when we get to the outer solar system, ice behaves much as rock does in the inner solar system, and we can get lots of icy tectonic features, icy volcanoes, when we look at the moons of these outer planets. And with 80 some moons to study, one large one around Saturn, and a number of medium-sized moons, and a large number of smaller ones, there is still a great deal to learn about the geology of the moons in the outer solar system. So that was our picture of the day for October the 17th of 2019. It was titled Moons of Saturn. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Interstellar Interloper. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.